Hello everyone. In today's demo, I'll be creating a basic Kickstart file and then using that Kickstart file for an automated installation of Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9.2 using VMware Workstation Pro. So I have the blog post pulled up and I'll put the link in the description. We're going to scroll down to where the demo starts. Take a quick look at the Kickstart file, but we'll actually use the Kickstart generator over at Red Hat and create another one. So if we start creating a basic Kickstart file, we'll start with the version, the directive to state what version of Kickstart we're using. So in this case, RHEL 9. Then we'll configure the language and keyboard settings, configure the time zone, set the root password, use the text installation method versus the graphical. We'll be installing from a CD-ROM or an ISO. Clear the master boot record on the disk that we're using. Remove all existing partitions. There's not any currently, as we'll be using a new disk. Initialize the disk label. Use automatic partitioning. Now with Kickstart, not the Kickstart generator that you'll see in just a second, but with the Kickstart file, you can get pretty advanced on your partition setups. We won't be going through that today, but just know there are a lot of options that you can add into this configuration file. And then finally, we'll install the server with GUI environment. This will not start the GUI by default. If you want to do that, you can run this statement here, and it will set it after installation. This is an example of the Kickstart file that I've already generated, but we'll go through the process. So if you'd like to follow along in the demo, there's a few prerequisites that you'll need to install. VMware Workstation Pro, the trial will be just fine. And I've got links out on the post. The Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9.2 ISO. You can grab that for free by setting up a Red Hat developer subscription. Learn more in a previous post on how to get that set up. I'll be using a PowerShell module called new ISO file. It's a PowerShell script I use to write the Kickstart file to an ISO. It's quick and easy to use, and you can grab that out on GitHub. Visual Studio Code, it's not required, but nice to have. So our first step, we'll need to open up the Kickstart generator tool. And again, if you haven't set up an account on Red Hat, you can do that for free. And then you got access to all of the documentation and the Kickstart generator tool. So we're going to start up here at basic configuration. And essentially, this is just a UI that you can use to begin creating that Kickstart file instead of starting from scratch. So the basic configuration, we're going to set the default language to English. Keyboard to English, and the time zone to the central time zone, essentially. Set the root password. I've set it to Automate SQL, and then just repeat that here. We are going to perform the installation in text mode. Graphical is default. We will be installing from a DVD or an ISO. You can install from all of these other locations, NFS, FTP, and so on. Partition, we're going to use automatic partitioning. So we're going to clear the boot record, master boot record, remove all existing partitions, initialize the disk label, and then use automatic partitioning. For the boot loader, we're just going to use what's provided here. And then for the packages, we're going to install the server with GUI package. This is for the category. I've just chosen servers. In the documentation at Red Hat, you can look through and see what's included with these different categories. I've just chosen server here. And then additional package groups. I haven't chosen anything for those. And then for the network, if you scroll down, I did not use the default here. I went to add. We can take a look at this and just edit. I named my network device link. The host name is rel9.localdomain, and then I am using DHCP. For SE Linux, I do want to enable the firewall, but I also want to allow SSH through the firewall, so I've selected that. And that's it. I don't have any pre-installation or post-installation scripts, as this is just a basic file to get started. And then once you've completed all of the choices, scroll back up and go to Show Text, and it gives you this. Basically, you can copy this into your ks.cfg file and save it. I did want to mention, since we're going to be using a kickstart file on an ISO, we have to give that ISO a label called OEMDRV, which is here. And this is mentioned in the post if you'd like to know more, but you can host that kickstart file on an HTTP server, FTP, NFS, or TFTP. We're just going to keep things simple and create an ISO. So I'll switch over to our demo machine, and just as a prerequisite, I've created a folder called rel9 demo, and then I've copied that ks.cfg, the kickstart file, down. The Red Hat Enterprise Linux ISO is here, and then this is the new ISO file PowerShell module that we'll be using to create, we'll actually recreate this ks.iso file. So we'll switch over to Visual Studio Code. You'll notice that I've already got the ks.cfg file opened, and at this point we'll be placing this file on an ISO using that new ISO file PowerShell module. So the first thing you need to do if you do use this to create your ISO is to switch into the directory where that PowerShell module is located. And then you'll want to import it into your session. So import module. If you're not familiar with PowerShell, that's okay. This is just a way to import this as a module. And then inside this PowerShell file, there's a function called new-iso file. And we're essentially loading this module into our session so that we can get access to that function. And once we've done that, we're ready to go ahead and create the ISO file. So we're going to be calling that function new-iso file. The source is our CFG file. Destination ISO is the ks.iso. And if you'll notice, this is important, the title. We're giving it the title of OEMDRV because remember, to use an ISO with that kickstart file installed, it has to be labeled OEMDRV, or otherwise the installation won't use it. So we'll go ahead and create that. And now that we've got it created, let's go to our directory just to make sure it's here. Yep, it's here. Now we're ready to create our virtual machine. So I've opened up VMware Workstation, and we're just going to go through the process to create a new machine. Custom, we're going to do custom instead of typical because we don't want it to auto start the installation. Hardware compatibility is 17.x. We're going to choose this option. I will install the operating system later. Click next. This is Linux, and I've already chosen Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9. And then you can give it a name. I'm going to call mine rel9 demo. Choose your location, wherever you want to install that VM. I'm going to choose one processor and 4 cores. And then I will choose 8 gigs of memory. I'm leaving the default there. Default is fine there and here as well. So we will create a new virtual disk. And I'm leaving the default of 20 gigs there. And that name is fine with me. Here, instead of clicking finish, actually, I'm going to go ahead and click finish. Before we start the VM, we need to set up our ISOs. So if you right click on the VM, go to settings, go to CD DVD, use ISO image, and we're going to browse to the RHEL 9 demo directory and choose our Red Hat Enterprise Linux installation DVD. Choose OK. I'm going to go ahead and click OK here, and then I'm going to go back into settings and click on the CD DVD again, click advanced. You'll notice that it says SATA 01. When we add another DVD, and this one is going to be our Kickstart ISO, so this one says 00. You'll want to switch this, otherwise the VM will try to boot from this one since it's the first one. And you'll notice that the 01 is the second. So I'm going to temporarily change this to 02, apply that, go back to my original CD DVD, go into advanced, and change this one to 00. And then change this one to 01. And then OK. And click OK again. And now we're going to start the machine and the installation should begin. You'll be prompted with two options. The first to test the RHEL 9 ISO and then move into the installation, or two, go ahead and start the install. I'm going to go ahead and start the installation. So just click anywhere in here and go up and select Install Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9.2. You could, by default, it's going to test the media. You don't have to do this. You can be completely hands-off, and it will go through the test, and then it will immediately start the installation. I've just chosen to do this to speed things up. But you'll notice that you won't be prompted for any additional input at this stage. Here you'll notice it is using the Kickstart file because our installation options are filled. Language settings, English, United States. Time settings, America, Chicago. Local media, we're installing from the local media. Software selection was the server with GUI. And installation destination. We don't have any pre-installation scripts, so it's essentially didn't do anything there. Now it's starting the install and it's starting the package installation process. So now this does take a few minutes to complete. We'll come back once it's finished and take a look at what we have. The installation completed. So now we'll log in and then we'll run a command called startx just to start the GUI and make sure that the environment was installed properly. We can ignore this. We did not register it with Red Hat, but as you can see, the GUI started. We can take a look around. You can use that Kickstart file to create additional users, and then you wouldn't have to log in as root, which is not best practice, but this was a basic example. Take a look at network settings. See, we're connected. So that's the end of the demo. We created a very basic Kickstart file and then installed Red Hat Enterprise Linux with very little interaction. So thanks for watching.